All right, greetings everyone on this Wednesday, March 13th, 2024. This is Marco Ponce of beingjustified.com with the Wednesday edition of the Watchman Report. And today on 313, we are going to be going in on the Jesuit Pope hitting 11 years as the Pontifex Maximus. We're also going to cover a quick clip from our film called The Prince of the Covenant, where we talk about what does it mean to be the Pontifex Maximus. And quite simply, it's this. He is the sovereign, aka the king of the city that the word of God says reigns over all the other kings of the earth today. In Revelation 17, it says, "And the woman which thou sawest is that great city which reigneth over the kings of the earth." The city being spoken of in Revelation 17 is on seven mountains, arrayed in purple and scarlet for the bishops and the cardinals, and is full of names of blasphemy, like Holy Father. If a man calls themselves Holy Father, that is as blasphemous as it gets, because that's what the Lord Jesus Christ called his Father in heaven when he prayed to him in John 17, speaking of 17. But either way, thank you for joining me on this Wednesday. And as you can see, we have images from the Pope right there as of today where his hat flew off. All right, take of it what you will, as the hat just flies off there. We got wheels falling off Boeing jets now. Like they say, we're running it until the wheels fall off and the hats fly off, because the end of the world is soon to start with the Prince of the Covenant, Prince Mohammed bin Salman, as we've been sounding the alarm since 2020. We are at the doors of that. So welcome, and we will be covering that and much more, showing us, as we connect the dots, how the last days are about to start. Many people are not rightly dividing right now. What have I said clearly since 2020? The beast is MBS. When he confirms the covenant with Israel, then the end of the world will begin. We are just living the buildup to it, especially after Operation Warp Speed. But I also wanted to remind you that we are no longer, I need to update this, we are no longer suspended on Being Justified at our YouTube there, but I do want to cool down on that. I don't want that deleted because we're on our second strike, but right now we are streaming simultaneously to Rumble, YouTube, X, Facebook, and Kick. Don't forget we're on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And all I ask of you is make sure if you are edified and you like this content, give it a like and also share it with those that you want to really wake up. Otherwise, follow us on X and Telegram for the latest news updates that we also collate for you here on the Watchman Report. If you don't want those updates, well, just know we're going to get you the biggest stuff here on the Watchman Report as we collate it for you. But if you want them in real time, follow us on X or Telegram. And before I proceed, I also wanted to cover a recent testimonial by a brother which shares my name, Marco Perez. Let's cover what he recently said via email. He said, "Dear Mr. Ponce, greetings from Michigan. I would like to express my gratitude for your ministry, your preaching, teaching of the gospel in Romans 3. Amen. That is the gospel, chiefly. And exposing the mystery of iniquity has changed my life. Amen. Opening those eyes up here on the Watchman Report." And it says here, "I used to be a deceived Christian until I came across your channel on YouTube." Amen. At least you are you're acknowledging you were deceived. Amen. That's where it starts. All right. The very interesting thing about being deceived is you never knew you were deceived until you know the truth. Now, let's continue. "Prior to finding your channel, I was just learning about Neom on YouTube." Amen. A lot of people think that Neom is Mystery Babylon in Revelation 17. No, as we've been highlighting in our film Esau is Edom, which we came out with last year, Neom is Edom, which is being rebuilt as foretold in Malachi. Now, this is what else he says. "That is when I became suspicious of Mohammed bin Salman, MBS. So I searched, is MBS the beast?" Hey, that's not a bad query right there. I like that. That's what people should be searching. Let me tell you right now, when you come to the knowledge that we so simply teach and preach here on the Watchman Report, and you go elsewhere, oh, you'll know who's lying. You'll know who's lying, because with the knowledge that Mohammed bin Salman is the beast, if Christian channels and prophecy channels are not even indicating him as a beast candidate. Most likely they call him the Antichrist. Then you know they're deceivers. But notice what he said here. He was searching for is MBS the Beast. Not bad, by the way. Good search. And it says here on YouTube, and began watching your videos. The more I watched the reports, the more I realized there is no denying what you have been proving. Amen. The Bible says prove all things, and we do so here. Now, notice what else he says. Now that I can prove my name is in the book of life, I realize the pastor at my local church preaches a false say a prayer and invite Jesus into your heart gospel. Oh man, is it not very clear that there's many on the broad way that leadeth to destruction, and few there be that find the gospel for today in Romans 3. Just by us preaching the true gospel of Romans 3, that alone should show you how many people are deceived. But like I said, there's few, not billions, not millions, maybe thousands. That's it. Now look at this. I have matured a lot in a short amount of time. This is what I wanted to highlight, because I've told my wife, I was like, listen, I got to get people caught up here, because many are deceived and they need a quick start guide here. All right, with the relative short amount of time that we have. I know that most likely people do not have the 3 years plus that I had to get established in the faith according to God's establishment commandment in Romans 16. We most likely do not have that amount of time. But what we do have is some time here that I can help you understand the true gospel, get your name in the book of life, and then who's the beast and what starts the end of the world, him confirming the covenant with Israel, and then what starts to play out after that, so we're able to rightly divide the word of truth, whether it was past, present, or future. That's how you rightly divide. Now, I'm glad to hear this from my fellow Marco here, Marco Perez. He has vocalized something that I have told my wife I am trying to do here with the Watchman Report. Part of this ministry is to help you get caught up here and not caught up in the rapture. Let's go harpazo. No, I'm not. I'm trying to give you a quick start guide into what we are about to live, the real end of the world started by the beast, Mohammed bin Salman. Now, notice what Marco says here. I have matured a lot in a short amount of time, thanks to you, and I desire to be taught aright by a faithful ambassador the way I have been from watching your reports. I sincerely request acceptance into your Bible school, and I've already added him to our free Bible school, which you could join at beingjustified.com/school. But he does say here, I testify that I have faith in the blood of Jesus as payment for my sins. I am truly justified by the gospel taught to me by you in Romans 3, and can prove it now also. Amen. Now, I do want to, if you're listening, Marco, also pay attention to this. Not only have faith in the blood of Jesus, but also in Jesus, the man, Jesus, and the message, the blood. All right. Those two things, believe in Jesus, have faith in his blood. Those two, you have to believe in Jesus. That is our hope, our earnest expectation that we know he's coming back. We could clearly see that by the stuff that we report on here. But let's continue here. I am truly justified by the gospel taught to me by you in Romans 3, and can prove it now also. Thank you for being bold for the truth, as we ought to be. All of us should be bold for the truth, especially right now as we see the end of the world about to start. And notice this. May our Father, amen. You have to understand who you are in Christ. You are a son of God because of the Lord Jesus Christ. You're not a Christian. You're not a follower of Jesus. You are a son, and you can now cry, Abba, Father. That is your Father. Amen. So I'm glad. See, Marco, you're also going to be more edified once you start getting into the Bible school as well. So may our Father comfort our hearts as we approach the end. Like Peter says, the end of all things is at hand once that deal goes down. But I did want to share that with you. Amen, Marco, my fellow Marco, my brother in Christ, and enjoy the Bible school, and feel free to reach out with any questions. But I also wanted to remind people to join our free email newsletter with over 2,000 people now on it. On our homepage and also on our blog, you can enter your email to be notified whenever we come out with brand new content. Like I said, we're working on a film called Corona Rage Hopefully I can get that out before the total solar eclipse, which we're also going to get into in a little bit. But also, do not forget to watch our films proving that MBS is the Prince of the Covenant that will confirm the covenant with Israel. And also, he is a child of Esau. He's an Edomite, rebuilding the land of Edom. The heritage of Esau, the land of Esau, which is in northwestern Saudi Arabia, which they call Neom today. Those two films can be streamed or downloaded at beatenjustified.com/beast. Make sure you check those out and share those with people. A lot of people have come to the knowledge of the truth here. Listen, I am happy to say I'm not after gain is godliness, but I do want the most amount of eyeballs to at least get the opportunity to see this and hopefully wake up and repent and believe the gospel and then get ready for the end, because I'm happy to say we have over 80,000 people that have watched The Prince of the Covenant when you look at all the different platforms, all right, whether it's on YouTube, Twitter, Vimeo. We've had over 80,000 at this point. All glory be to my Father. Now, as a faithful ambassador, which is health to your eternal soul, I'm also called to warn every man chiefly about this. This is the sun. This is the lake of fire. That's why the sun was darkened when the Lord was on the cross, when the power of the sun was placed on his soul as he was the Lamb of God, the God's burnt offering. Why do you think the Jews had a burnt offering? It's because the Lamb was burnt on the cross. That's why the sun was darkened and the whole earth was darkened. That's what happened at the cross. That's why the Lord was so scared of the cup. The cup of the wrath of God is this. And this is what everyone will go to if they die in their sins, just as it is written here. And whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. And for those of you still not believing me about the sun being the lake of fire, check out our film called The Ring of Fire at beingjustified.com/ring. Why do you think they call the annular solar eclipse the Ring of Fire? Because the sun is the lake of fire. Now, let's go over to the Authorized King James Bible. That is the pure word of God in English for today. Every other Bible in English after the King James has at least one lie, and no lie is of the truth. So throw away those Bibles, get yourself a King James Bible, and if you have something like the Geneva Bible before the King James, well, why don't you get a King James? Because the Word of God is purified 7 times. The King James is the 7th edition of the Protestant Bibles. Now, in the King James, in Romans chapter 3, is where you are justified today. It's not in John 3:16, it's not in Romans 10, and it's not in 1 Corinthians 15. Anybody preaching another gospel, which is not another, is accursed of God, according to Galatians 1:9. So you remember that when you watch these fools try to tell you about saying a prayer, or that for God so loved the world, John 3:16. No, today, this is where you're justified. So hearken unto the gospel of the grace of God. For all have sinned, all were dead, all have sinned, and come short. We don't fall short. We were never there. And it says, and come short of the glory of God, being justified, just like our website's called. That has to do with receiving the righteousness of God imputed to your soul for free. It's a free gift by God today, freely by his grace, through the redemption, that's forgiveness of sins, that is in Christ Jesus. That's why you believe in him, whom God, that is the Father, hath set forth to be a propitiation. That means he was made sin for us who knew no sin, through faith in his blood. That is the message, because it is the blood that maketh an atonement for the soul, and without the shedding of blood is no remission. And look at this, to declare his righteousness, not ours. He lived a sinless, spotless life for 33 years, to declare his righteousness for the remission of sins that are past, through the forbearance of God, to declare, I say, at this time, his righteousness, that he, God the Father, might be just. Remember, God is just, and sin will be paid for. With your free will, you can reject this message. But you know what? When you die in your sins, go to hell and then the lake of fire, you will pay for your sins yourself, because God is just and sin must be paid for. So, do the following while in the land of the living, because he might be just, God is just, and the justifier. God is the justifier of him. That is in the Word of God, where you can literally point and say, that is me right there, which believeth in Jesus. Do that today. Believe in Jesus. Have faith in his blood, because it is the blood that maketh an atonement for the soul. He paid for your sins, just like Paul said, for ye were bought with a price. So if you're a believer today, don't forget, you're paid for. Ye were bought with a price. What is that price? The sinless blood of God. That's it. That's the price right there. Otherwise, that is the gospel. Now let's proceed to our guest of honor today, the Jesuit Pope, who turns 11 years old as the Pope today, and he could very well be the last Pope, who is mentioned in Revelation 13 at the end there as the second beast. The second beast is the false prophet, and that is going to be the person that aids the first beast. I can tell you right now, fully persuaded, it's established by God. The first beast of Revelation from the sea, the Red Sea, is that Arabian leopard, Prince Mohammed bin Salman. Guaranteed, fully persuaded, I've already proven it, and I'm telling you it's established by God. That is the first beast. Now, we have to just wait and see who the second beast is going to be. Will George be the second beast, or will he die and make room for Pizza Bala or something like that? But now, I did want to do a small teaching here on Revelation 13 about that second beast. And it says here, and I beheld another beast. That's after Mohammed bin Salman right there. And I beheld another beast. And later, they give him the title, the false prophet. So the beast and the false prophet. But this other beast is the false prophet. And look at this. And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth. The earth. That is typically in relation to Israel. So we'll see. We'll see if it's George or it might be Pizzaballa, the first Latin patriarch of Jerusalem that became a cardinal for the Vatican. That sounds like the earth to me. We'll see here. And it says here, and he had two horns like a lamb. Oh, likes to call himself the vicar of Christ. And he spake as a dragon, speaks like a devil, like the devil Satan. He's the great dragon. And he exerciseth all the power of the first beast before him. This is after Mohammed bin Salman does the deal with Israel. 42 months later, he's killed and risen from the dead, and he's doing some stuff, all right? And then the second beast, the false prophet, will do some stuff with him. We're going to see what kind of stuff he does right here. Notice George, Pope Francis, he has not done any of this, which we're going to talk about. And it says, and causeth the earth and them that dwell therein to worship the first beast, because the first beast, Mohammed bin Salman, got killed by a sword and came back to life. How do I know that? Let's just keep reading. Whose deadly wound was healed. Mohammed bin Salman has not been killed by a sword yet. All right, let's rightly divide here. And he doeth great wonders. The false prophet, the final pope, is going to do great wonders. Right now, Pope Francis could barely walk. So that he, the false prophet, maketh fire come down from heaven like Elijah did. They're probably going to say, that's Elijah preparing the way for the Lord. Yeah, that's the Antichrist right there, as people say. But look, George or Pope Francis has not called down fire from the sky, okay? Because this has not come to pass yet. This comes to pass by the middle of the tribulation going forward. Like I said, Mohammed bin Salman's the beast. He does the deal. 42 months later, they kill him. He comes back to life. And this starts to happen right here, okay? And he maketh fire come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men. And that hasn't happened, obviously. And deceiveth them, the world is going to be deceived by these satanic miracles that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles, satanic miracles, which he, the false prophet, had power to do in the sight of the beast, Mohammed bin Salman, after he comes back to life, after being killed by his sword, saying to them that dwell on the earth that they should make an image, that is the abomination of desolation, that could speak. They're going to say, let's make an image. He's going to say specifically, the false prophet is going to say, let's make an image to this man that got killed by a sword and came back to life. This is going to happen by the middle of the tribulation. To make an image to the beast, which had the wound by a sword, like the Saudi sword, and did live. Because Judas is the eighth king, and King Mohammed is going to be the seventh king for a short space. And he had power. The false prophet has power to give life, a satanic life, unto the image of the beast, the abomination of desolation, that the image of the beast should both speak with the power of artificial intelligence and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. Listen, lately we saw an AI robot in Saudi Arabia molest a reporter by touching her butt. But listen, we're all going to wish that molesting AI robot would be the worst case scenario, because soon an AI robot is going to cause people to be killed that don't worship it. That's what's coming up, y'all. And he causeth, that is the false prophet, the final pope, and he causeth all. By the middle of the tribulation going forward, the coronavirus vaccination was not the mark of the beast. That was not it. Nobody called fire down from the sky to deceive people to get that thing. You know what they did to have people receive the COVID jab? They gave joints for jabs, no job, no jab. Heck, you know what they even did? This is when I know it was even bad. Like, this is the worst thing that I saw with the COVID jab. They had people get the COVID vaccine to have sex with a prostitute, all right? They were giving brothels. Brothels were giving jabs for whores. Jabs for whores. That's the worst I saw. But notice, that was all people had to do to persuade or coerce people to receive the pink venom. Don't forget the pink venom.
This that pink venom, get him. Shirt till you don't like. Whoa.
The COVID jab was what the music industry calls the pink venom that goes straight to your dome like whoa, because we're about to get to the three woes of the Great Tribulation. But the Great Tribulation. But look at this. The COVID jab, guaranteed, fully persuaded, was not the mark of the beast. You better count your blessings if you got the COVID jab. All right, you didn't get something good. It's just a bioweapon. That's what jab means, just a bioweapon. You did not get something good, but at least it's not the mark of the beast. So save your soul. Get your name in the book of life. But at least it wasn't the mark of the beast, which is the unforgivable sin. Now, let's continue. And he, the false prophet, causeth all, the whole world, by the middle of the tribulation going forward, after MBS gets killed and risen from the dead, both small and great, rich and poor. Listen, that brings a lot of joy, because I know everybody's going into this blender. We are about to hit the hour of temptation, which is the final 42 months by the middle of the tribulation going forward. That is what the Bible calls the hour of temptation, which cometh upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth. We are all going to be tried to take that mark. Just like Esau sold his birthright because he was a little hungry. We might all get a little hungry coming up. Just don't take that mark, the mark of Esau. Because remember, the beast is a child of Esau, and a child of Esau is going to have all of us have an Esau moment coming up. All right, we're all going to probably get to the point where we might be starving, and we want to get that mark to buy or sell. Don't let that be you. I'd rather starve, for real talk. We're all going to be tried coming up. Because remember, there is also no pre-tribulation rapture. You're going to be here. Like those people, you ain't going nowhere. You ain't going nowhere because the resurrection, notice I don't say rapture. The resurrection, that's the word you should use, is at the last trump, after the seven of the great tribulation, at the day of the Lord when he returns. But either way, I digress. Look at this. And he, the false prophet, the final pope, causeth all, both small and great, rich and poor, we're all going into this blender, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand. That is biotechnology right there. That's why Saudi Arabia wants to be the global biotech hub, which equals 666 with the practice of gematria. But look at this. Receive a mark equals 666 with gematria. In their right hand, it's going to be inside the right hand or inside their forehead or in their foreheads. Nobody got the COVID jab in their forehead, okay? And don't try and tell me that it goes straight to your dome. Listen, it has not happened yet. No fire came down from the sky with the final pope. And look at this. And that no man might buy or sell in the hour of temptation. Say he that had the mark, or the name of the beast, Mohammed bin Salman, or the number of his name. Remember, the number of the beast is specifically to the number of his name. When you think the number of his name, that is with the practice of gematria of taking letters to numbers. That's how you get a name having a number. But whenever you hear the number of the beast, 666, that is specific to the number of his name. Here is wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast. For it is the number of a man, not a religion, not a city, not a country. No, it's one man. And his number is 600, 60, that's 60, and 6. That is 666. Now, I've already proven it. I've already showed you it's established by God. MBS is that man. We are here. The end of the world is about to start. But notice what we see here with the practice of gematria. 600, 60, and 6 equals a value of 313. That is why today, March 13th, is when the Jesuit Pope started his pontificate. Look at that face right there. All right, that's what nightmares are made out of. But look at this. I do now want to remind you that before the Jesuit Pope came into being, lightning strikes the Vatican twice. That is Satan counterfeiting God, because when God does something twice, it's established. Well, Satan, which fell from heaven as lightning, he struck the Vatican. That's the great city of Revelation 17. He struck it with lightning twice. Before Pope Ratzinger, he resigned shortly thereafter, and then this guy came in, which could very well be the false prophet. We shall see very soon. But with all that said, let's take a look now at the 11 years of Pope Francis, as told to us just today by Rome Reports.
Following the resignation of Pope Benedict XVI, some cardinals believed the next pope should convey a sense of closeness and inclusivity. March 13th marks the 11th anniversary of who they elected, Pope Francis. Throughout these 11 years, Francis has embraced human suffering in all forms, from the child who lost his father to refugees living with hopelessness. The cardinals who elected Francis wanted a pope with energy to reform the Roman Curia, and he has done just that. Pope Francis continued the transparency and anti-corruption measures initiated by his predecessors. For example, by instituting external figures such as the Auditor General, who is in charge of supervising the balance sheets of institutions linked to the Vatican, that until now had operated freely.
Nulla è perfetto, tutto può essere.
Nothing is perfect. Everything can be improved further, and as the Pope himself says, corruption, rather than a sin, is a disease that needs to be cured. I believe that the economic reforms initiated by Pope Francis and Pope Benedict make it more difficult to perform unlawful acts. The Pope worked to focus the Curia on what he calls the Church's primary mission, evangelization. On the other hand, some of his decisions have generated controversy, a recent example being his declaration titled Fiducia Supplicans that allows for the pastoral blessings of same-sex couples. The declaration insists that the blessing is in no case an endorsement of the relationships, but some bishops argue that it creates confusion. In the last 2 years of Francis's 11-year papacy, his health has begun to decline. It all started at the end of January 2022.
E mi permetto di spiegarvi che oggi non potrò andare fra voi per salutarvi perché ho un problema nella gamba destra, si è infiammato un legame nel ginocchio, ma scenderò e vi saluterò lì e voi passate per salutarvi.
Since then, Pope Francis has had mobility difficulties, although this has not prevented him from continuing to travel. But respiratory issues have made his daily activities even more difficult.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno. Anche oggi io non potrò leggere tutto. Sto migliorando, ma ancora la voce non mi dà. Sarà Monsignor Braida a leggere la catechesi.
Over the last year, these respiratory problems have had him admitted into the hospital once, just before Easter 2023, and caused changes in his schedule from the end of November until now. But Pope Francis has shown no sign of wanting to resign. Since the start of his knee problems, he had to cancel or postpone two international trips. But he has still made 9 trips in the last 2 years and continues to plan more. In August, he plans to visit Pacific Islands, although it is not certain if his health will allow the 87-year-old Pope to do so.
All right, so now, as you can see, a lot of that was just your stereotypical Rome Report stuff on what they call the Holy Father. But now, let us go to the scripture of truth at one of the best scriptures on the Society of Jesus, which is truly the Society of Judas. Now, on the screen, we have a gram of truth that shows the current Jesuit general along with the Jesuit Pope together, like black and white, like good and evil there. And remember, I'm just telling you, they're closing out the show here. The Jesuits are the militia of the Vatican, the great city of Revelation 17. And they told us when they elected the last Jesuit general, they are rowing into the deep. That is the kingdom of the beast. And in 2 Corinthians, this is the perfect scripture for the Jesuits. And no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. Therefore, it is no great thing if his ministers also be transformed as the ministers of righteousness. Oh, they call themselves the Society of Jesus, whose end shall be according to their works. And let me tell you, if you need a brief history on the Jesuits, man, you'll be surprised. Pretty much every country has expelled the Jesuits because of their wicked works. They are the ones that infiltrate, that create subversion, that create civil wars. Those are the guys that have been getting expelled since their inception, essentially. But with the practice of gematria, of taking letters to numbers, Society of Jesus equals 56, like the amount of times Satan is in the King James Bible. But also, Satan's ministers equals 56, because that's what they are. The Society of Jesus is the Society of Judas, and they are truly Satan's ministers. But if you don't want to listen to me on them, why don't you listen to their leader? Let him tell you what a Jesuit is.
When this Janakum 32 tried to define Jesuits, what was the words they use? No, a Jesuit is a sinner. A Jesuit is a sinner. And that is a demonstration that we are not sinners once, we are sinners many times. No? So we need to really to overcome that reality, that resistances that are in our interior.
Now, let's go over now to Proverbs 23, where it says, "For as he thinketh in his heart, so is he." If you think you're a sinner, oh yeah, you're a sinner. And these guys are the wolves of Loyola. They are the wolves in sheep's clothing that the Lord warned us about. They wear sheep's clothing, but they're really wolves. They even show you that with their mascots, with all these Jesuit universities. Just look at the logo. They have two wolves on it. They tell you who they are, by the way. It's not like they're hiding it. And again, also, for your edification, remember, when you believe in Jesus, you have faith in his blood, truly, well, you're in Christ, and God sees you in his Son, who never sinned. So you're not a sinner anymore when you're a believer. He sees you in his Son. Don't forget where you're at. I'm in his body. I'm part of his body, his church, the pillar and ground of the truth. But let us now proceed to a clip on a segment from our film from 2022 called The Prince of the Covenant, where I talk about Mystery Babylon the Great, that is the Vatican. And we also go into the definition for Pontifex Maximus, which comes from the ancient Roman Empire. Because in the book of Daniel, we go from the kingdom of iron to the kingdom of iron and clay. That is the final kingdom before the return of the Lord, and that is the revived Roman Empire. Don't forget, the Vatican is in Rome. It all lines up perfectly. Check it out.
And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth. And he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon.
Y esto es la historia del fracaso de Dios.
This here, in this item, is the history of God's failure.
After celebrating Mass for Father Jacquemel, who was murdered by terrorists in July, Pope Francis went to St. Peter's Square. There he visited thousands of pilgrims who flocked to hear his catechesis. He explained that Jesus makes a request to imitate him. He is not a master who imposes impossible burdens. Everything he asks for, he has done before. He is not a faraway, distant God. He prefers to be among the people.
Gesù non era un principe.
Ours is to plant the seeds. God sees to the fruits of our labors. And if at times our efforts and works seem to fail and not produce fruit, we need to remember that we are followers of Jesus Christ, and his life, humanly speaking, ended in failure, the failure of the cross.
Sisters, good evening.
Buonasera.
Voi sapete che il dovere del conclave era di dare un vescovo a Roma.
You know that the duty of the conclave was to give a bishop to Rome.
I fratelli cardinali sono andati a prenderlo.
My fellow cardinals went and found one all the way at the end of the world, but here we are.
Now, we're going to end this particular clip right here. This is from our film called The Prince of the Covenant, where we talk about the second beast, which I already taught on, is the false prophet, which is the final pope. Now, I wanted to go over to Wikipedia to show you, why do they call him the pontifex? Notice, the pope, also known as supreme pontiff, Roman pontiff, or sovereign pontiff, is the bishop of Rome, head of the worldwide Catholic Church. And by the way, Catholic means universal church. Yeah, for the devil. And look at this. And head of state or sovereign, aka king, of the Vatican City State. Now, you got to remember, the Vatican is the smallest country on earth, but the way they control the earth is through the government, which they call the Holy See. That's how they reign today, according to Revelation 17, 18. Now, what you have to also notice is that they use the term pontiff or pontifex maximus. And pontifex maximus is what the Roman Caesars used to call themselves as well, as the component of being the highest religious figure of the ancient Roman Empire. And like I said, we're in the final revived Roman Empire, which is the kingdom of iron and clay from the book of Daniel before the second coming. Now, that's enough of our film, The Prince of the Covenant. That is from our film. So if you have not seen it, make sure you check it out. But I now want to go over to some little details here as to why the Pope became, or I should say, why the Jesuit Pope became Pope on March 13th, because you can write it as 3/13 or 313. And as I've already shown you, with the practice of gematria of taking letters to numbers, 600, 3 score, and 6, which is the number of the beast, that is a value of 313, like 313 on March 13th. Now, another very interesting takeaway that I saw with this particular number is in Isaiah 14, where the only mention of Lucifer is, "How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning." That's who he was. He was the anointed cherub of God. He is, you know, was Lucifer, son of the morning. And it says here, "How art thou cut down to the ground?" Because he's no longer Lucifer. He's the adversary, the devil, Satan, that old serpent which deceiveth the whole world. Now, look at this, "which this weaken the nations." The nations are weakened by the devil. Pretty clear. Now, one of the things that I wanted to highlight here is Lucifer. The word Lucifer, the name, the heavenly name, by the way, God gave him that name. He was the anointed cherub that covered the throne of God. So listen, for all you Satanists out there that like to call him, you know, this archangel, this angel. No, he was the anointed cherub. You better put respect on that name. Listen, he was higher. You remember, we got the angel, the archangel, the seraphim, the cherubim. Yeah, and he was the highest of the cherubim. He was the anointed cherubim. And look at this. I did want to highlight this here. Lucifer is word number 313 of 856 of Isaiah 14. So in Isaiah 14, the word Lucifer is the 313th word. That's kind of freaky, y'all, how they do it by the numbers here. All right, so that's why the Jesuit Pope became Pope on 313, because it also has to do with Lucifer being word number 313 and also 600, 3 score, and 6 being 313. Don't forget, the Jesuit order equals 201, because we're living event 201 right now. It's their event. And notice, priests of Lucifer equals 201. Yeah, they are the chief priests of the devil. I already told you, they are Satan's ministers at the top. I could tell you right now, Satan himself has probably had meetings directly with this guy and the Jesuit general. I can tell you he has had face-to-face meetings with those people. Now, another thing that I wanted to highlight is he is Pope number 266. And Lucifer, son of the morning, equals 266 with the practice of gematria. Now, another freaky thing is that he was consecrated to the Catholic Church, or Mystery Babylon, 666 months after his birth. And look at this. The official title from the Vatican is His Holiness Pope Francis, which equals 666 with the practice of gematria. So those are some things that I wanted to highlight with Mr. Jorge Mario Bergoglio. Now, I did want to also bring to your attention that, remember, the first beast is Prince Mohammed bin Salman. The second beast is going to be the false prophet and final pope, which could be the first Jesuit pope, because here are some other interesting finds. Mohammed bin Salman equals 942, and that is 666 in base 12. But with the reverse cipher, Franciscus, the Latin name, because Latin is the official language for Rome, is 942 as well. I don't find that a coincidence. But let us now go to some news, or I should say, a reminder from the Vatican in regards to their lineup for the upcoming end of the world. Remember, how does it really all end? We are going to get to the point. All right, don't forget, Mohammed bin Salman is the beast. He's going to do the deal. Then the end of the world will begin. 42 months later, they're going to kill him. He comes back to life. But eventually, right before the Lord returns, there are going to be three unclean spirits that come out of the mouth of the beast, the false prophet, and the dragon, the devil. They're going to be the alien gray frogs that unite the world to fight the Lord on his return. That is how it starts to culminate towards the end. But here we have a mention recently by these deceivers, which I've already highlighted before. I've already renounced this man, and I've already highlighted this man with the rapture deception. But pretty soon, like I've been telling you, we might have deception on top of deception. Remember, they might compile the pre-tribulation rapture lie with the alien deception. So be ready for that. And here we have another allusion to that by these two big deceivers that have a big following. And notice, it involves the Vatican this time. The Vatican's big deception. Of course, the Vatican is the great city of Revelation 17, which is Mystery Babylon the Great, the mother of harlots and abominations of the earth. Of course they're going to help with the alien lie. But with that being said, let's see how they're going to promote the alien deception on top of the rapture deception. Because don't forget, when you say rapture, the word is resurrection, and it's truly at the last trump. And don't be like Hymenaeus and Philetus that were saying the resurrection is past and think you are left behind to overthrow the faith of some, like the book of Timothy says. But with that being said, let's go into how they are pitching the lie upon lie. Check it out.
So talk about the Vatican.
Oh, yeah.
The Vatican is connected with this, as unbelievable as it is.
Yeah.
And years ago, you know, Tom Horn did some stuff about this.
Yeah.
But the Vatican is very much connected to this issue.
Very much connected. And the more I went down that rabbit hole, Pastor Jimmy, the freakier it got. Unbelievable. It was just like, wow. I knew that they were off base in general, period, but man, they have bought into this alien UFO lie on a massive scale.
Right.
And so we demonstrate, we even share on the documentary, here's the screenshots from the Catholic pages. This is not some JoeSchmo.com, wacky, no, this is from them. This is really what they're saying. But believe it or not, the Vatican has been in search for ET for decades now. They have an entity called VORG, V-O-R-G. The Vatican Observatory Research Group. And they're in a desperate search for ET. And this is coming from their astronomers. Most people don't realize the Vatican has astronomers.
Yes, they do.
Right? And first of all, their first mistake is they believe and promote the lie of evolution.
Really?
Yes, they do. And it's on tape and they admit it. And so they believe these higher evolved, and right there that tells you you're dealing with a lie.
Right.
Because the whole premise, which we have a whole chapter on, of aliens is what? They're a higher evolved race. Wait a second. If evolution is not true, and it's not, then you just lied to me before you even got off this ship.
Right.
So it's a lie. And where do lies come from? John chapter 8. Right. Satan's a liar and the father of all lies. It's satanic. It's a demonic. So they reveal themselves. Anyway, the Vatican promotes that same lie. And then, of course, that lie was started 150 years ago by Charles Darwin.
Yep.
For our time. It isn't just to get us to disbelieve in God's existence, it's to prepare us for this alien lie, right? Because you need something to explain away the rapture of the church.
Right.
And so you first have to get away from God's existence and listen to the scripture, evolution, so you can fall for the second lie, higher evolved aliens, so you can fall for the next lie, explain away the rapture of the church. Vatican promotes that, it's on tape. They have their astronomers, they're looking for ET. Now here's where it gets really wild. It's bad enough that you believe in the lie of evolution. But they say the reason why they're in search for ETs is because they believe in their cosmology that the aliens have not experienced a fall like the rest of us.
Oh, wow.
Therefore, and this is their words, not mine, we must be prepared when they show up that we need to listen to what they say about God, Jesus, and the Bible, and the gospel. And even if it disagrees, yes, what we're used to being taught, we need to listen to them because they haven't experienced the fall. So therefore, they rationalize they must have a better report, a better understanding, because they don't have a fallen nature like the rest of us.
And it couldn't be farther from the truth, because think about it. The three unclean spirits that look like frogs, which are really the alien grays coming up, are really spirits of devils. Oh, yeah, they fell all right. And also, don't forget what Romans 8, verse 22 says. For we know that the whole creation groaneth and travaileth in pain together until now. Now, remember, these aliens, they're going to present themselves to unite the world. Listen, we should already know this is how it's going to culminate. We have the book. Don't forget, if you're a believer, you got to know some big characteristics from God. He knows the end from the beginning and calls the things that be not as though they were. We already have his completed, perfect, pure word of God in English. It tells us how everything ends. And there's going to be three unclean spirits that look like frogs that are really the aliens that are going to unite the world to fight the Lord on his return. Think about that deception. But let us now see some old school evidence. We've already covered this before on the Watchman Report, and we have the Jesuit Pope not too long ago saying that he would baptize aliens, and also says, who are we to close doors? And again, this is the scripture. Remember, a lot of people always like to go off on tangents and tell you about the Nephilim and the giants and the sons of God. Listen, it's so simple in Christ, the simplicity that is in Christ. In two sentences, in Revelation 16, they tell you about what the aliens are all about and the purpose. In two sentences, you should know what the aliens are and what they're going to be doing. This is it right here. It says, and I saw three unclean spirits like frogs. That's why they look like that. For they are the spirits of devils. Those are Satan's angels working miracles. Notice, they don't need Project Bluebeam. They know how to do miracles themselves, which go forth unto the kings of the earth and of the whole world. What is the purpose of the aliens? To gather them, to unite the world to the battle of that great day of God Almighty. That is the purpose. We should know how this ends. Now, I also want to tell you, they're going to come out of the mouth of the beast, the false prophet, and the dragon. And that's why every time I see Mohammed bin Salman, look at that thing he's doing with his throat right there. Some people tell me he has Tourette's. No, I know he's the beast. And most likely he has a devil in his mouth. Like they say, oh, you got a frog in your throat. Oh, yeah. Three unclean spirits like frogs. One of those frogs are going to come out of his mouth. One of those devil frogs is going to come out of his mouth. That's why you see him doing that stuff with his mouth. And like we see in the film called Knowing with that Satanist, Nicolas Cage, they show you what's going to happen with these three unclean spirits. Look at that. They're going to unite the world. It might look something like that. But again, as a faithful ambassador, we're watching here for when the beast does the deal with Israel. And again, I wanted to point out these dates coming up, which one of them is going to be this Friday, which is 42 months exactly after the Abraham Accords being signed. Then don't forget, we are currently in Ramadan, which ends around the total solar eclipse, which makes an X over America that then leads into Passover, and then May 1st, the Illuminati birthday, and also Beltane for all the witches, and 666 days after the Georgia Guidestones were blown up, which also leads into May 6th or 5-6 in the year of the Great Dragon, which is also Holocaust Remembrance Day. So these are some chief dates here that we are looking for as to pushing the envelope here as to getting us to the end of the world, started by this man, which has a frog in his throat. But another thing that I wanted to talk about is also from March 13th, 2013, when the Jesuit Pope became Pope, to the total solar eclipse coming up is 4,044 days. Well, just remove the zero value and you have 444, which Lucifer equals 444. Man, they're doing it all by the numbers. Remember, the last total solar eclipse to the COVID jab was 1211 days. Then from the jab to the next solar eclipse that we have next month is 1211 days. So the devil and his mystery of iniquity positioned the jab right between these two solar eclipses. If you think that's a coincidence, go back to sleep, because disease X is coming when America gets a big fat X, y'all. Don't forget, they don't have to unleash anything. Right now, 70% of the world got deceived to receive what the music industry calls... That is Eminem with his song called Venom. And he also, in another song called Godzilla, said the following.
Fill him with the venom and eliminate him. Fill him with the venom and eliminate him. Fill him with the venom and eliminate him.
Fill him with the venom and eliminate him. And let me tell you, if you have not been eliminated and you got that pink venom, well, they're probably going to use you for the next one with a flip of a 5G switch. So be ready. Get your name in the book of life. And just prepare for seeing some wild stuff, because the devil has been hiding his power. But like the Nightwalker song says, he's not going to hide his power pretty soon. And speaking of Venom, here goes Black Pimp's cover to their song called Pink Venom. And notice, it's got a snake on it. All right, that old serpent's Pink Venom equals 666. But they have another movie for the franchise called Venom coming out. And it was just announced yesterday, which will be coming out in theaters October 25th, called Venom, The Last Dance. Oh yeah, we're about to have The Last Dance, y'all. And notice, this movie is coming out 201 days after the eclipse and 201 weeks after the Pink Venom jab was unleashed on December 14th, 2020. They're doing it all by the numbers as we live Event 201 by the Jesuit Order, the chief militia of the Vatican. Now, what do I want to cover now? This is a short video that I made because of just watching, as we do here on the Watchman Report. And it reminds me, as I continue to watch, all we are seeing are the devil's mystery of iniquity, Jesuit theater. We're just watching a big fake show. But it reminded me of a song by Imagine Dragons called Bones, which is about the jab. And in the song, they say, "Is this entertaining? My patience is waning." That is like the devil telling us, "Are you entertained? Are you entertained by my mystery of iniquity? Because my patience is waning." And then it says, "Our patience is waning." Like the devil and his angels, our patience is waning. Is this entertaining? Because pretty soon, you might get to see a bunch of raging zombies get activated. So with that being said, enjoy this quick little compilation I made of just the Jesuit theater, along with the music video for Bones, and also some solar eclipse action by Elon Musk's baby mama Grimes. Check it out.
My patience is waning. Is this entertaining? My patience is waning.
Yep. My patience is waning. Is this entertaining? Because pretty soon I'm about to start up these zombies here that got deceived to receive the jab and then get activated like Rwanda genocide style. So get ready for that. And like I said, when I talk about zombies, I'm talking about like raging ragers from Rwanda with the Rwanda genocide. That it was most likely where they tested the jab that 70% of the world got now. And notice, this is rather interesting. On the day of the eclipse, April 8th coming up, leaves 267 days in the year. Well, World War Z, or WWZ, equals a value with prime numbers only of 267. That is when World War Z might begin. So get ready, y'all. You better have a zombie contingency plan. I think that's how we're going to get to the Kingdom of the Beast, just like we see with the Netflix show called Kingdom, where the crown prince will be our only hope against a zombie plague, just like the show on Netflix called Kingdom. So, again, another thing that I wanted to highlight here is how Prince Mohammed bin Salman equals 222, the Beast of Revelation equals 222, and this is another interesting find here. From the date, the last birthday of Prince Mohammed bin Salman, August 31st, 2023, to the total solar eclipse coming up, is 222 days. Listen, I wouldn't be surprised that he might confirm the covenant on the day of the eclipse. I wouldn't be surprised. And then once this man confirms the covenant with Israel, the end of the world will begin. And what do I know about the end of the world? Perilous times, full of danger, will start. It's going to start with this man. Remember, Russia, Ukraine, COVID, they don't start the end of the world. This man starts the end of the world. The Corona Prince, the Crown Prince. Don't forget, Corona in Spanish means crown. And he is the Corona Prince, because the Corona King cometh. And that's going to come by the middle of the tribulation, which is Judas, the eighth king, which is of the seven of Saudi Arabia. And here's another interesting find with the eclipse. I don't tend to dabble too much. I try to keep myself simple concerning evil. And notice, the Lucifer sigil, which all the Satanists like to use, it looks like a straight-up eclipse, right? This is the symbol for Lucifer that the Satanists all like to use. Remember, they're not Luciferians. They really worship the devil, okay? That's just his name when he was in the third heaven. But notice, it looks, when you put it on an eclipse, it looks like the penumbra and the umbra shadow from the eclipse right there. And notice, from the book of Job, the Lord tells us, I will not conceal his parts, talking about the devil, Leviathan, nor his power. The devil has not hindered, the Lord is not going to conceal the power of the devil. It is the devil himself that has concealed his power, nor his comely proportion. He's pretty big, all right? And as Leviathan, the fire-breathing red dragon of the book of Job, remember, Leviathan, the piercing serpent, even Leviathan, that crooked serpent, that is another name for the devil, Leviathan. But let us go now back to the crux of the matter, because we're gonna now pivot to the war again. And the crux of the matter is MBS plus Israel deal equals the end of the world, the last days. That's what starts everything. And here on the screen is more proof and telling you that it's established by God, because the number of his name is the number of the beast twice. Notice, it's established by God, MBS is the beast. All right, not Marco. It's established by God. And also remember, even in the earthly, there's no crown prince deputy. That lets you know he's the only one. There ain't nobody else after MBS. There's no crown prince deputy in the kingdom of Esau from Arabia. And the beast tells us every day we're getting closer to the end of the world. And that might be coupled with three different scriptures at least, where he's going to part God's land and also allow the Jews to build the third temple. But when he does that deal, 42 months for the two witnesses, then the beast is killed in rhythm with Judas in him, the eighth king of Revelation 17, and then Judas in the body of MBS is going to rule the world for 42 months before the second coming. Now, there's more to it than that, and if you want to get the details and print this out to help you rightly divide what's coming up, the real end of the world, well, go to beingjustified.com/Daniel. And now, back to the war, because what we are seeing here is just proof positive as to how it's all about to play out as it is written, as the Lord has given me the understanding to help you understand here on the Watchman Report. Well, we constantly see this. A Palestinian state is the only path leading to peace with Israel. That's what a Saudi official said. They've been saying that. And that's what's going to part God's land most likely, as Joel chapter 3 verse 2 says. And we also have mentions recently about peace and safety, because sudden destruction is coming. And now, as we are on day 159 of the war in Israel, Gallant, the Minister of Defense in Israel, hints at imminent Rafah operation. Well, Rafah equals 201. Are you surprised? Nope, you shouldn't be, as they do it all by the numbers. But the defense minister also highlighted that defeating Hamas will lead to peace with Saudi Arabia to start the end of the world. It's like there's, if you have eyes to see, they're basically saying, when we beat Hamas, we can start the end of the world. Y'all should be happy. Yeah, right. Look at this. Saudi cabinet also reiterated the need to stop Israeli aggression on Gaza. Remember, this is Esau, this is Jacob. This is Esau, this is Jacob. When Jacob does a deal with Esau, the end of the world will begin. But notice how 201 just keeps showing up. Not too long ago, Bibi was addressing the nation 201 days after his birthday. But another thing that we're seeing today is from Bibi's last birthday to today is 144 days, like Jesuit order equals. But also from what we see here, let me take a look. From today to Bibi's next birthday is also 222 days. So, like order out of chaos equals 222. So again, I wouldn't be surprised. We're about to go into the Ides of March. And also, as we've reported, they have given Hezbollah a deadline on March 15th, the Ides of March, to, I don't know what the heck the deadline is. But the Israeli Defense Force gave Hezbollah in Lebanon a deadline of the Ides of March. So I would imagine some crazy stuff is going to start to build up here as we are just, like I said, after the war, we're just working up some beast peace and then the end of the world will begin. All right. It's order out of chaos with the devil's mystery of iniquity in this present evil world as he is rowing into the deep on a course to the kingdom of the beast. That is all biblical. We are at the doors with it. Like the Lord said, for the time is at hand. But speaking of Israel and the war of Israel, I wanted to highlight some sellouts. Recently, we had Floyd Mayweather. Some of you may know him, that famous boxer. Here he is. He's another sellout to the devil, the god of this world. Here he is with a black hat that has three stars of Remphan on it. That is not the Star of David. That is the Star of Remphan Saturn. And when you have three stars of Remphan, that is 666 on his hat. And here he is at the Western Wall. He's another sellout in the Holy Land recently. And speaking of sellouts, these are sellouts in the kingdom of the beast. We have U.S. model Taylor Hill wearing Saudi attire. Notice, Saudi Arabia is all popular all of a sudden. And we have the one of the most famous soccer players that is also the Saudi tourism ambassador wearing some Saudi attire as well recently. When you have eyes to see, you can see these are all sellouts to the god of this world. When the devil gives you what you want and he wants something in return, well, when he has his puppets, when he tells them to dance, they dance. Look at that. Here goes Sheikh Messi and here goes Taylor Hill. They're dancing for the devil. But speaking of the war, we have the kings of the East also preparing here for the time of the Great Tribulation coming up. Russia announced that its warships have reached Iran to participate in joint exercises with Iran and China in the Gulf of Oman. These are the kings of the East, man. And also, don't forget, we recently had Putin say no indication. Putin said they're not scared to use nukes, but we had the U.S. State Department say no indication Russia is preparing to use nuclear weapons in Ukraine. That's what the White House just said. And I wanted to remind you that don't forget about the alien savior card. The aliens have been noted to go around nuclear sites to disable nukes. They can come to potentially be the saviors coming up. Don't forget that card. And notice, top Vatican aide backs Pope and warns of nuclear escalation in Ukraine. Listen, this is all order out of chaos. And as we head to the end of the world, don't forget, I've already told you, the main religion is going to be Islam because Islam's Messiah is the scripture of truth's beast. And their Jesus is the scripture of truth false prophet. And their Antichrist is the scripture of truth's Lord Jesus Christ on his second coming. The end times of Islam is the opposite of the scripture of truth. And that is going to be the main religion. And notice how it's getting popular. I wanted to take some time now and show you what's happening in New York with Ramadan. Check it out. So, listen, New York is turning into the New York Caliphate. Don't forget how the New York mayor, after coming from Israel, announced that they can do the Istighfar prayer on Fridays. So that's another big slap in the face for all those 9/11 families, because don't forget, the public narrative is that Saudi Arabians, from the majority stake of it, were the terrorists that helped take down the tower. So it's basically Esau terrorizing New York again. But speaking of Ramadan, this was also the scene with over 40,000 deceived Muslims in Jerusalem as they face Mecca. They face Mecca. Don't forget. And Mecca, Saudi Arabia equals 666 with the practice of gematria. And as I've been saying, Islam is going to be the main religion for the end of the world because Mohammed bin Salman, from the birthplace of Islam, is going to be their Messiah, the Al-Mahdi, the rightly guided one, after he gets killed by a sword and has Judas the son of perdition, enter his body. This is a clip about the white horse Mahdi that we had in our recent film called Esau is Edom that shows you the mystery of the Muslim Messiah, which is Judas in the body of MBS. All coming up. It's all about to go down. Check it out.
And I saw one of his heads, as it were, wounded to death. And his deadly wound was healed. And all the world wondered after the beast. And they worshipped the dragon which gave power unto the beast. And they worshipped the beast, saying, Who is like unto the beast? Who is able to make war with him? And there was given unto him a mouth, speaking great things and blasphemies, and power was given unto him to continue 42 months. And he opened his mouth in blasphemy against God, to blaspheme his name and his tabernacle, and them that dwell in heaven. And it was given unto him to make war with the saints, and to overcome them. And I saw when the Lamb opened one of the seals, and I heard, as it were, the noise of thunder, one of the four beasts saying, Come and see. And I saw, and behold, a white horse, and he that sat on him had a bow, and a crown was given unto him, and he went forth conquering and to conquer. Given him over all kindreds and tongues and nations. And he causeth all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads, and that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name. And all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him, whose names are not written in the book of life of the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world.
And there goes those three cubes with six sides on them for 666 right there with the Abrahamic family house as they are preparing to worship Judas in the body of MBS coming up. And that is the deep, dark world exclusive that my father has given me that I was definitely the first one to show on the internet here. And that is the deep, dark mystery behind that symbolism that you see with the Scottish Rite Freemasons and also the Knights of Malta. Because when you see this double-headed phoenix, that is really Mohammed bin Salman and Judas Iscariot, which equals 999, but 999 equals 666, because it's going to be Judas the 8th king in the body of MBS, the 7th king of Revelation 17. And notice, Mohammed bin Salman and Judas Iscariot has 33 letters, just like you see right there. And he's going to receive his crown by the middle of the tribulation going forward, with a crown going forth conquering and to conquer. And that's why you also see the sword there, because that's how MBS is going to be killed. So that is the world exclusive. Let me tell you, no one's even coming close to this, but that's what that symbolism is for. Otherwise, remember, the Jesuits are the militia of the Vatican, and they're going to work tirelessly here to unite the world religions to worship Judas, because the Jesuits have even wrote a book called Hope for Judas. And another thing I wanted to remind you of right now, as we are living the beginning of the end of the world that's about to start, we are already seeing scripture come to pass with prophecy in regards to the beast, Mohammed bin Salman. I wanted to remind you that Daniel 11:21 has already been fulfilled with MBS. Daniel 8:25 has already been fulfilled with MBS. MBS is the little horn of Daniel 8:9. He is the leopard of Revelation 13, and he's rebuilding Edom like Malachi 1:4 said would happen. We are seeing scripture already get fulfilled with MBS. And there is a reason why he wants to be the global biotech hub, because the mark of the beast is going to be biotechnology. It's going to be technology in the biology. And global biotech equals 666. Because don't forget, we are on a course with Vision 2030. Divide 20 by 30, what do you get? And whose vision is it? The vision of MBS, which equals 666. For at the time of the end, which is started by him, shall be the vision. Blessed are those servants whom the Lord, when he cometh, shall find watching, like we do here on the Watchman Report. And I know nobody else is coming close to this. So show your thankfulness by donating at beingjustified.com/donate. For God loveth a cheerful giver, and not because I desire a gift, but I desire fruit that may abound to your eternal account. And at bare minimum, you know what you could do? Listen, here goes a mouse. Here goes a mouse. Here goes a finger. I want you to go to the like button and click, all right? That doesn't involve much. You can do a click, and also, why don't you copy and paste these links and share the links, because you already know I'm censored. I should have millions of views. Many people have said that. When this information opens their eyes and then they see how many views I get, oh, you should clearly see I'm being suppressed. Otherwise, while we still have time, join our free Bible school at beingjustified.com/school so you can start learning the Bible according to God's establishment commandment so that Christ can be formed in you. And don't forget about our three pillars here. We know that the Word of God in English is the King James Bible that is pure, all authority. We know that justification is in Romans 3. And we read the Word of God according to the commandment of Romans 16. That is what keeps us safe. Otherwise, there goes God's warning to you. Make sure your name is in the book of life. While in the land of the living, that is your number one thing before you check out. Get your name in the book of life. And if you want to learn how to do so, go back to the beginning of the report or go to beingjustified.com/justification, where we cover the gospel from Romans chapter 1 to Romans 4. Otherwise, that's going to be it for us today on the Wednesday edition of the Watchman Report. This is Marco Ponce of beingjustified.com, your faithful ambassador in Christ's stead. Thanks for joining us, and we will see you on the next one. Farewell. Beware of the Ides of March.